गुड आफ्टरनून
मैम। बेस्ड ऑन लास्ट क्लास पोर्शन आई हैड गिवन यू अ स्मॉल होमवर्क, हैव यू डन दैट?
यस मैम।
टेक आउट योर बुक क्विकली, लेट मी हैव अ लुक एट इट। आई हैव गिवन फ्यू वर्ड्स टू राइट एंड लर्न द स्पेलिंग एंड आल्सो फ्यू क्वेश्चंस टू फाइंड आउट आंसर्स फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट। ओके लेट मी सी। दिया विजु ओके, निरंजन ओके, श्रीहरि, मानस, ओजस ओके, वेल डन, जानवी ओके, गुड।
मैम इसमें वीडियो विजिबल?
नो सिद्धि, योर वीडियो इज नॉट विजिबल। नवनीत ओके, देन रुद्रा,
सॉरी मैम आई फॉरगॉट इट।
हाउ कम यू फॉरगेट मंजिमा? मयूग, रुद्रा, मरिया, ओके ओके। हाउ कैन यू फॉरगेट चिल्ड्रन व्हेन अ होमवर्क इज गिवन टू यू? Which means that you haven't opened the textbook till now. Last Wednesday our class got over, and Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, you had 4 days of holidays. Oh, okay, Adidev and Rayan. Okay, okay, good. Maria, okay. Risa, okay. Oh, okay, Felix. So 4 days of gap is there. Still, you are saying you forgot.
Ma'am, Manav says he done the homework.
But he has done. He has done. Where is Manav?
Ma'am, he can't on his video.
Where is Manav? I can't even find his name.
Ma'am, there at the bottom row. He's at the bottom row.
Okay.
Ma'am, can you see?
Yes, Siddhi, I can see. Okay, okay. Keep your book closed, all of you.
Ma'am, is it visible?
Not clear, but still, I believe that you have done your work. Close your book. Mayug, give me the spelling of nibbling. Close your book and give me the spelling. Do not look anywhere else. Give me the spelling of nibbling. Quick. Mayug. No response. Maria.
Ma'am, yes, ma'am. I can't unmute.
Now it's okay.
N-I-B-B-L-I-N-G.
Okay, good. N-I-B-B-L-I-N-G. Nibbling. Okay, Maria, give me the spelling of monotonous.
M-O-N-O-T-O-N-O-U-S.
Very good. M-O-N-O-T-O-N-O-U-S. Monotonous. Next, Devarsh, slurping. What is the spelling of slurping? This video is
S-L-U-P-R-I-N-G.
S-L-U-R-P-I-N-G. Slurping. Okay, very good. Next word. Rudra, what is the spelling of shudder?
Yes, ma'am.
Shudder. What's the spelling?
Which word?
Shudder.
S-H. U. D-D.
Very, very E-R-E-D. Slow. Very slow. Did you write and learn?
No.
That is why. You're thinking whether it is correct or not. That is clear from the way you gave me the answer. Okay, Janvi, give me the spelling of shuddered.
S-H-U-D-D-E-R-E-D.
Yes, S-H-U-D-D-E-R-E-D. Shuddered. Okay, next word. Rayan, give me the spelling of beamed. Beamed.
B-E-A-M-E-D.
B-E-A-M-E-D. Okay, good. All right. Then now let's quickly discuss the question answers. Navaneet, what was the first question that I gave you?
Ma'am, the first question is, how did Mohini spend her time during holidays?
What is the answer?
Mohini decided to read books and spend her time during holidays.
Mohini? How did Mohini spend her time during the holidays?
Ma'am?
Yes, Navaneet, give me the answer. Mohini, where are you?
Can I say Riza?
Amini, your voice is not clear. Okay, I'll ask somebody else.
Ma'am, Sridhari.
Sidhi. Siddhi.
Ma'am, can I say Rizza?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, Mohini spent her time slurping ice creams and drinking mango panna.
That's all? Lazing around in the afternoon.
Lazing around in the afternoon.
Yes. Mohini spent her time by slurping ice creams, drinking mango panna, and lazing around in the
and
afternoon.
And lazing around in the
afternoon. Okay. Next question. Aditi, why did Mohini's mother scold her?
Yes, ma'am. Mohini's mother scolded her because she wasn't waking up and did not want her daughter to be late for school on the very first day after the holidays and set a bad example.
Very good, very good. Perfect answer.
Thank you, ma'am.
Mohini's mother scolded her because she was reluctant to wake up in the morning and her mother did not want her to become a bad example on the very first day of the reopening. Okay. Third one. Diya, what did Mohini had for her breakfast?
Mohini had mint chutney sandwich for her breakfast.
Very good, very good. Perfect answer. Mohini had mint chutney sandwich for her breakfast. Fourth question, Aditi, what were the words that repeated in Mohini's mind? Aditi, what is answer? I can't hear you, Aditi. No, not audible. Srihari.
Ma'am, fourth question answer. Miss Nalini told that everyone should speak about the place they visited during summer break. These were the words that repeated in Mohini's mind.
Yes, very good. Very good answer. Miss Nalini told the students that everyone has to speak about the places that they have visited during the summer holidays and it will account for 50% of the total marks. So this is what repeated in Mohini's mind. Fifth one, Rissa. How did the class greet the teacher?
Ma'am, in a very long tune. By saying good morning.
How did the class greet?
Ma'am, can I tell ma'am in a good mood and saying good morning very for a long time.
Ma'am, can I tell Sanvi?
Yes, Tanvi, what is the answer?
I'm in a monotonous way.
If you write the answer in a word, I will not give you marks.
Ma'am, can I?
I have told you many times your answer should be in complete sentence. Felix, what is the answer? No, not audible.
Ma'am, not can audible. I?
Glenn Biju.
Ma'am, the class greets teacher with energetically and very in a long tune.
Ma'am, can you hear me now?
Yes.
Ma'am, can I? Ma'am, I will say the class greeted Miss Nalini monotonously.
The class greeted Miss Nalini in a loud and monotonous voice. Okay.
In a loud and monotonous voice.
Yes, that is the answer. It is exactly given in the chapter. The class greeted Miss Nalini in a loud and monotonous voice. If you can add, if you want, you can add that dialogue also. Good morning, Miss. That one. All right. Then the last question. One more question is there. Yes. When did Miss Nalini visit her family? Devash, what is the answer? Where did Miss Nalini visit her with her family?
Ma'am.
Denika, what is the answer?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, Miss Nalini visited Shimla with her family.
Very good. Miss Nalini visited Shimla with her family. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
All right. So, children, let's continue with our chapter. I'm not that happy with all of your performance. Some of you haven't read the chapter. Some of you did not do the homework. Some of you have not written the answers perfectly. So I want you all to read. Reading text is compulsory. Okay. Every day, make it a habit to read the text. Loud reading. You just practice loud reading. And whenever there is a homework, make sure that you complete it. Do not make any excuse. Okay. Learn the spelling of the words. Try to find out the answer from the text and write for the question answers given. All right. So let's continue. Open your text, page number 35. So in the story, all the places you will go, we have mainly three characters: Mohini, a little girl, her mother, and Miss Nalini, her teacher. Okay, she spent her summer holidays by slurping ice creams, drinking mango panna, and lazing around. And once the holidays got over, on the very day of reopening, Mohini was a bit reluctant, unwilling to get up from her bed in the early morning. So her mother scolded her for setting a bad example. She asked whether she wanted to set a bad example on the very first day of the reopening. And then Mohini got up, she brushed her teeth, she dressed up, and she sat in front of the table to have mint chutney sandwich. At that time, some words repeated in Mohini's mind. Those words were the words of Miss Nalini. Yes. So what were the words that repeated in Mohini's mind? Everyone has to talk about the places that they have visited during the summer vacation. And it accounts for how much marks? 50% of marks. Yes, 50% of marks. So that very thought made Mohini quite disturbed. And then we know the reason why Mohini has not been taken for a trip. What is the reason? What is the reason? What is the reason? This is the reason. You just say it aloud. You just say it aloud. I can make it out from your lips. Yes. Yes. What is the reason? No money. Huh? Yeah. Her father died when she was just 3 years old. And her mother financially helped the family by stitching clothes. Yes. By stitching clothes, she financially supported. So the money that she earns by stitching is quite good enough to send her daughter to a good school, but not for a trip. So that is the reason why Mohini was not able to go for the trip. And then we find the reopening day of the school. All the children gets into the class eagerly and they started chatting. They started talking. And then we find that the teacher enters the class and all of them stood up and they greeted the teacher in a loud and monotonous voice. Very good, very good. Loud and monotonous voice. I want all of you to repeat it, okay? The children greeted the teacher in a loud and monotonous voice. Very good. Okay. And then we find that the teacher is herself setting an example for the students. The teacher told that she went with her family to Shimla. Yes, very good. She went with her family to Shimla during her summer holidays. Did she enjoy the trip? Yes or no? Did she enjoy the trip? Yes, she enjoyed the trip very much. She says that it's a beautiful hill station. It's the capital of Himachal Pradesh. And everything is different there. The food, the climate, and even the trees look so different. And then we talk about the experiences of each child. The children started to talk about one by one. Who was the first? Who was the first student? What was his name? Abdul. Is it Abdullah? Is it Abdullah? No. It's not Abdullah, but it is Abdul. Yes. Where did he go? Where did he go? Kochi. Yes, he went to Kochi. Why? What's the reason? His daddy lives there. His daddy is living there. So how did he go? By train or by bus? By cycle? By plane. Yes. He went to Kochi by plane. And did he enjoy the trip? Yes, he enjoyed the trip very much. He was so excited to talk about his trip. All right. Okay, now let's continue. Okay, so the first one was not Abdullah, but Abdul. Okay, for exam, do not write Abdullah. If a question is asked, name the student who visited Kochi during summer holidays, means your answer will be Abdul. Okay, Do not write Abul or Abdullah, Abdul. All right. Now we are going to see the second child. Let's see where she went. The name of the second child is Putul. Just underline it in the text. Putul. Putul. North Indian names. These are all North Indian names. Putul. We are not so much familiar with the name. Okay. So mark these names in the text. Putul. P-U-T-U-L. Can you see the letters? Can you see the letters? Is it difficult for you to see? Should I choose some other color? Yes, I think I'll choose dark blue. Okay. Putul. P-U-T-U-L. It's the name of a child. Okay, name of a girl. So Putul visited her village in Odisha near Bhubaneswar. Putul spoke about her experience next. Miss, I went to my village in Odisha near Bhubaneswar. Okay, where did she go? She went to Bhubaneswar. The village is in Odisha near Bhubaneswar. The best part, underline the place that she visited, Nandankanan Zoo. Okay, it's a botanical garden zoo. And she liked when she really visited the zoo. So we know that in zoo, all kinds of animals will be there. And let's see what are the things that she loved. Crocodiles and snakes. Oh. Can you think about looking at crocodiles and snakes are so interesting? Huh? I would just show both the hands like this. Oh, Felix likes it. Siddhi likes it. But my answer is like this, okay? Crocodiles and snakes are not at all interesting. So disgusting creatures. So Mohini also thought the same way. Yikes, thought Mohini. Yike, what is yike? Yike, it's an expression of surprise. An expression of surprise. Yikes, Mohini thought. So what was Mohini thinking? How can be this crocodiles and snakes so interesting? How can it be? See, I'm a person who is very much afraid of snakes. I just don't like to see snakes even on the pictures. I know you have so many things to tell me, to share it with me. Once I am done with the chapter, I'll just unmute. Okay, I'll just give you permission to unmute. So I'm a person who personally, I can't afford to see the snake on the picture. Crocodiles, I can adjust, but snakes, no matter. Even if I see them on the newspaper or in the magazine or even the mobile sometimes, I'll just throw it away. If it comes on the screen, I'll just throw it away. And that's such a kind of frightening, disgusting creature. So what do you mean by disgusting here? Disgusting. Underline the word. You have to learn the spelling as well as the meaning. Disgusting. Disgusting means a strong feeling of dislike. Strong feeling of dislike. There is no chance for liking these creatures at all. Strong feeling of dislike. Glenn, what is your opinion? Huh? Do you like to see them? Unmute.
Yes, ma'am, I like to see them.
Oh, very sad. I shouldn't have asked you. All right. Okay. So Mohini thought that, how can be these snakes and crocodiles so interesting? They're very, very disgusting. Okay. Then we are coming to know about the third student. Okay. The third child's name is Steve. Underline the name. Steve. S-T-E-V-E, Steve. Okay, spelling should be learned as it is. S-T-E-V-E, Steve. Do you know where he went to visit during his summer holidays? Yes? Yes, Felix, Paris. Yes, Paris. Wow, Paris is a beautiful place, right? Yes. Have you ever been to Paris? Anybody else in the class? No. You haven't been to Paris. All right. Okay. Where is Paris situated? Where is Paris situated? Yes, Niranjan, France. Paris is situated in France. It is regarded as fashion city of the world. Fashion city. Okay. Paris is the capital of France and it is also fashion city of the world. All the fashion comes in Paris first. Okay. So, Steve got an opportunity to visit Paris. Let's see, what are the famous places that he went to? We visited many museums there. Look into your textbook, all of you, when I read. We visited so many museums there. I was so bored. So sad. He did not like visiting museums. Puradana Vastu Kendram, is it not? In Malayalam, we would say Puradana Vastu Kendram. It's a place where you can see old monuments. So he did not like. He was least interested in that. We also visited Eiffel Tower. Wow. Eiffel Tower. It's pronounced as Eiffel Tower. That's great. The best part was the visit to Disneyland. How many of you like to go to Disneyland? Yay, Disneyland. Kids' favorite place. Disneyland. You can see almost all the cartoon characters there, right? Okay. Yes. So the best part was the visit to Disneyland. The entire class was listening eagerly to his description. Eagerly. What do you mean by eagerly? Who will give me the meaning of eagerly? Who will give me the meaning of eagerly? Sarah? Yes. Eagerly. What do you mean by eagerly? Sarah, unmute. Where are you? Unmute, unmute.
Ma'am, so interestingly.
With a great interest. Yes, correct.
Yes.
With a great interest. Eagerly means with a great interest. So all the students listen to what Steve said with a lot of interest. Okay. I would like to show you some pictures, but I'm not sure whether you will be able to see. Let it get loaded. I'm going to take you to Odisha. What is there in Odisha? Nandankanan Zoo. Okay. Botanical Garden, Nandankanan Zoo is there. Then after that, after coming back from Odisha, we will go to Paris. We will go to Paris. Okay. So let me see whether we'll get a flight or not. It will take some time to get loaded. Anyway, I haven't taken any pictures of the animals, especially crocodiles and snakes. You cannot find it here on the screen. Okay. All these pictures we have seen. Some delays there. That this is something that I don't like about. Let's wait for quite some time. Maybe because the network issue. All right. Anyway, we will continue. I think I'll get back to the pictures later. Is that okay? Yes, thank you. Good children. All right. If I'm not possible to show you the pictures here, I will actually send it through WhatsApp. Okay, so that you can have a look at the pictures. So let's continue. So Mohini felt uncomfortable in her seat as it was her turn to speak next. So where was Mohini sitting? She was sitting in one of the corners of the classroom. Okay, she was a lot worried about what to speak in front of the whole class. So she was feeling uncomfortable because it was her turn to speak. What will she say? Everybody would laugh at her. She stood up, took a deep breath and spoke. Miss, this summer vacation, I visited the library. Yes, fantastic place, right? How many of you love to visit library? Aditi, Aditi, Felix, Rudra. Okay, rest all like this. Sarah like this. Devarsh like this. Okay, okay, all right. You just like to visit or you just love to read? What is your answer? You love to read. Okay, visiting is not enough. You have to get the books one by one from the cupboard and then you have to open it and then you have to read it. Okay, only then it will become worth. All right. So Mohini, our little girl, the main character in the story, picked out so many books from the library and then she started to read. What? Her neighbor Rima started laughing. Fantastic laughing. Neighbor. What do you mean by neighbor here? Neighbor means? What do you mean by neighbor? Who is going to give me the answer? Manjima. Unmute.
Ma'am, a person near in our home, right?
House, house. Home is different, house is different. I'll make it clear with the example. Do you think that home and house is the same? No. It is different. It is different. House means it's just a building. Okay. But home means when father, mother, children all come together, when they share their feelings and they share emotions, when they share love with each other, it becomes a home. That is why you say a sweet home. And not a sweet house. Okay, sweet home. Okay, a combination of all these feelings. Okay, so home is different, house is different. So according to Manjima, somebody who just stays near to a house is a neighbor. Agree? Agree? Yes. But according to the story, is that meaning correct? According to the story, no, the meaning is not correct. So who is going to give me the answer now? Navani, according to the story, give me the answer. What do you mean by neighbor here?
Ma'am, in the story, it means they're near her.
Yes, the one who is sitting next to her. Okay, suppose if Janvi and Diya, both of them are sitting next to each other, Janvi will be Diya's neighbor, Diya will be Janvi's neighbor. Okay, understood? The one who is sitting next to your seat is known as neighbor. Oh my goodness, it's... What's the time now? 2:56.
Yes, ma'am, it's 2:56.
Only a few more minutes. Come, 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 come. Let's complete it fast. So, yeah. So her neighbor, Rima, started laughing. Soon the entire class was making fun of her. Everybody started to laugh. And what happened? Mohini started to cry. She started to cry. Tears came out of her eyes. And she looked at the board. She was facing the class. Till now, but when the friend started to laugh at her, she turned her face towards the board, feeling embarrassed. Embarrassed means ashamed. Okay, ashamed. Enough, all of you. Let Mohini complete what she has to say. Miss Nalini nodded at Mohini with a smile, encouraging her. So the teacher is very supportive, very encouraging. Okay, she scolded the other children. Do not laugh. Enough, enough. Stop laughing. And let her speak. Mohini cleared her throat. She cleared her throat. She was crying. Okay. So her voice broke in between. She cleared her throat and she wiped her face. Wiping her face. Yeah. Okay. Tears came out. So she had to wipe it off. She wiped her face and began. This summer vacation, I decided to read as many books as I could because Dr. Seo says in one of his books, the more you read, the more things you will know. The more that you learn, the more places you will go. So what happens when you read? When you read, you will get a lot of information. You will get a lot of knowledge. Okay. Yes, information and knowledge. And when you learn something, what happens? You feel like going to the places. For example, when you read a lot about America, United States of America, you feel like going to America. Okay, that's what is said here. The more you read, the more things you will know. The more that you learn, the more places you will go. When I read different books, I was transported to another world. Suppose if you're reading the story, fairy tale, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Huh? Have you all read that story? Yes, most of you have read Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. You will be taken to different imaginary world. Am I right? Yes. So that's it. Reading helps us to move to an imaginary world. I read books. Now, underline the books that Mohini has read. I read books about magical trees, animals that could talk, princes and princesses, witches and giants, magical spells and curses. Okay, so she read so many books. She read so many books about different types of stories. Then she also read about different cultures. She read about various people like Mahatma Gandhi. Underline all these are important. Mahatma Gandhi, Albert Einstein, Martin Luther King, and Mother Teresa. I visited several places while sitting in the library and I learned a lot. Okay, so reading gave her a lot of information and she visited all the places through imagination. Miss Nalini rose from her seat and hugged Mohini. What do you mean by rose? Rose is the past tense of? Past tense of? Rice. Not R-I-C-E, the rice that we eat. This is wrong, okay? What is the spelling? R-I-S-C. Okay. Rose is the past tense of rise, which means she stood up from her seat. She got up from her seat. She was sitting there. She got up from her seat and she hugged. And she hugged Mohini. Teacher became so happy to hear that she read so many books and she got more and more knowledge. The teacher said, to explore the world, we didn't have to travel. All we need is an open mind and willingness to learn. Willingness means readiness. For example, only if you are ready, you will be listening to my class. Okay. Even if your mom and dad says, listen, 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 you will not listen. Only if you are ready to listen, you will listen. Okay. Everything around us is waiting to be explored, to tell us a story. Okay. So whatever that we find here, everything has a story of its own. For example, even this book has got a story. Okay. The pulp of the tree has been taken, then it has been taken into the factory, then papers were produced, then it was binded, everything. See, the cover design, coloring, printing, everything. Everything in the world has its own story. Okay, so if you're ready to explore, then you can do it to a great extent. Okay, so that is all about our story. So we have come to the end of our
chapter. Eiffel Tower.
Eiffel Tower. Oh, yes. This has got eyes.
It's my sister's, ma'am.
Oh, okay, all right.
Ma'am took Eiffel Tower from Paris and
okay.
Now we need, you cannot.
We have completed our chapter. And one more thing I wanted to tell